Gaffney failed to return with an outside working party, and the alarm was raised when the party returned to the prison at lunchtime. We'll have a full report in our later bulletin.
Bloody Margot.
I mean, what would you do,
Mrs. Margot? Someone's fiddling with my car. Hey! It's Margot Gaffney.
How can you be so sure it was Gaffney?
I'm not. I just heard Mrs. Morris calling her.
You know Gaffney? You did time with her?
Yeah, of course I know her.
Then how come you didn't recognize her?
I got to the window first. She took one look at me and raced off before Judy knew what was happening.
I'm a funny old codger, Miss Bryant. I suppose the force has made me a bit cynical over the years, but I find it a bit hard to believe that Gaffney would go to all the trouble of coming here from Barnhurst and then leave without even saying hello. I mean, it's not polite, is it?
Yeah, well, she's not the polite type. Look, I know it sounds bad. I wish to God I had a better story to tell you, but I'm telling you the truth. I got too much riding on this place to mess it up, messing about with escapees. You guys would close me down in a couple of minutes.
The house is trying to cooperate with the police.
What? Yes, that's right. I mean, ask Inspector Grace. He'll tell you.
Message from VKC, Senior.
Excuse me, ladies. You were right, Miss Bryant. Gaffney is not the polite type. According to this, she was just involved in a hit and run. Unfortunately, the victim is in a serious condition.
You stupid bitch! You stupid bitch!
Fashion.
Yeah, well, it's got nothing to do with this game either. Hey, has anyone ever heard of, what is it?
Diorism.
Diorism?
No.
No, no, but I'll get it off.
All right, I won't argue. What about dioptric?
Yeah, well, why didn't you put that in the first place?
Where do you think you're going? I want to put some money on the Barkers, don't I?
Go for your life. I'm not stopping you.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means I'm not doing the book no more, all right?
No, it's not bloody all right. You can't just take our money and then toss it.
Oh, stick it, Chrissie. I'm not doing it, so forget it.
Well, watch it, Lawson.
Sorry, Mrs. Powell.
Mrs. Powell?
Well, well. So now we haven't got a book anymore. I wonder what's going on.
With Paddy Lawson? I wouldn't even try to work it out. She's mad. I mean, really mad. Mm. She should be in a hospital, not here.
Don't worry, we've had worse than her. You'll get used to her.
No, I won't. But I'll be out of here soon, thank God.
I wouldn't thank him too soon if I were you.
You amaze me, Latham. A male nurse turns up and you get everything but leprosy.
But I'm not having you on, Mrs. Powell. Straight up. I've been feeling a bit dicky since dinner.
Oh, you'll live. Get back.
Well, how come Lizzie gets to see him so much? She on some kind of special deal or something?
You don't give up, do you? Okay, let's have it your way. But he's probably gone home. Come on. Oh, I thought you might have gone. Don't suppose you've got time to fit one more in?
Well, not unless it's serious.
Hardly. It's Latham. She's had stomach pain since dinner.
Oh, well, in that case, I'd better see her. I ate here myself tonight, so I can sympathize with her.
Yeah, well, I'm off home, so call the staff room when you're finished, will you? Mm-hmm. Okay, Latham.
Hi. You left it a bit late, didn't you?
Yeah, I'm sorry. I must have been having a good time, though, because I didn't know what time it was.
Well, that's okay. Now, what's your problem?
Nothing.
Sorry?
I just came to see you, didn't I?
Oh, I see.
Oh, I hope you don't mind. It's just that you're real nice to talk to. And you sort of... I don't know, you sort of understand me. Not like them other morons. You're not mad at me, are you?
No, of course not. Why don't you sit down?
Ta. Shall I take my clothes off in case someone comes?
I don't think there'll be any danger of that. Well, how did your day go?
Oh, you know, same old bleeding routine. No, I'd tell a lie. I've got a new cellmate since I last saw you.
Oh, and what's she like?
Penny? No, just a normal crim.
Not Penny Seymour?
Yeah, that's her. Why?
Well, she's a prostitute, and they should never let her in with someone like you.
Hey? Oh, yeah, yeah, I see what you mean. Oh, still, I don't mind, not really. Mind you, I don't know how they could do it for money. Sort of seems dirty somehow, don't it? Different horses for different courses, I suppose.
You know, you're a very fair person, Chrissie. Did you know that?
Oh, yeah, bleeding super crim, that's me. Mind you, don't you get me wrong. Now, if they'd have put that Paddy Lawson in with me, well, then I would have cried blue bloody murder.
Oh, why?
Why? Because she's a bleeding nutcase, that's why.
No, Chrissie. Sick, yes, but she's not mad. No, with the right treatment, she could be just like you or me.
Oh, get off.
No, I mean it. She's got what we call an aggravated phobia. And lots of people have the same thing. They're scared stiff of spiders, snakes, heights, and in Paddy's case, confined areas. Claustrophobia.
Well, then how come she don't freak out in her dorm?
Well, solitary is much smaller than her cell, and who knows, maybe she's all right with other people around. But no one likes to be on their own, do they?
Now that I can understand. Well, it's why I came to see you, isn't it?
You there, Murray? Open up, will you?
Who are you?
John Travolta, who are you?
Look, just tell Murray Margo wants to see him, will you?
Sorry, mate. Look, Murray's shot through. Why don't you do the same?
Perhaps I can help you, Gaffney. Swan's the name. Detective Constable Swan.
Sorry, love.
Morning. There's a message for you. A senior detective Herbert. They have found your car and they would like you to go to the station to answer a few questions.
When?
Yesterday, according to this.
Any mention of Margot Gaffney?
Oh, yes, they found her. Now, come on, what is all of this about?
I'm sorry, Colleen, I'll have to tell you when I get back.
Yeah, all right. Off you go. Bye. I'll just find someone to fill in for you.
Hi. You working this morning?
No, I don't think I will. What do you make of that?
Oh, bugger if I know. Latham blows so hot and cold, I can't keep track of her. Lil, go and tell Chrissie you want to talk to her.
Yeah.
We might as well find out straight from the horse's mouth.
Yeah, what's up?
Thought you might be able to tell me that. I didn't think you and Punchy Paddy were on speaking terms.
Oh, that. Yeah, well, I was wrong, wasn't I?
Well, you usually are, but what changed your mind this time?
Well, I had a little chat to Mr. Murray yesterday.
A little what?
A little chat, and don't you be dirty. Anyway, he reckons she's really sick.
Yeah, between the ears.
Well, that's what I thought, didn't I? But he reckons she's got this phobia. Says she'll be right as rain with the right treatment.
Did he give it a name?
Claustrophobia. Anyway, is that all? Because I've left me brushing myself.
Yeah, yeah, that's all.
Do you believe her?
Yes, I think I do.
I lost my memory once and no one would believe me, not even my mates. It was bloody lonely.
I already told you that, Senior.
Oh, yes, that's right, so you did.
In fact, to be quite honest, I may have even left the keys in the car. I mean, I don't think I did, but I couldn't swear to it one way or the other.
Well, we've all done that to some time, Mrs. Morris. Forgetful beggars, aren't we? I mean, Miss Bryant here can't even remember meeting Gaffney.
I didn't forget. I never saw her. What's that for?
I'd just like to check something, Miss Bryant. How's your arithmetic?
Okay, why?
Convert £2.09 into dollars and cents and let me see what you get.
What's that got to do with anything? What's all this about? They're from the...
Halfway house?
Yes, I know. I can see you wrote the prices on the tags. Identical.
So?
So Gaffney was telling the truth when she said you gave them to her.
Bull! I was upstairs with Mrs. Morris.
I don't doubt that for a minute, Bryant, but I also think you knew Gaffney was downstairs. What about you, Mrs. Morris? Have you anything to add?
Nothing. Except that I object to the trickery you use.
That's sure right, Mrs. Morris. Unfortunately, if I objected to people withholding information, I'd be laughed at. I'll be interested to hear what you say in court when you're under oath.
Court? Am I charged with something?
No, you're okay, but I'm booking Bryant for assisting an escapee.
Oh, God, you scared me to death.
Your solicitor's here to see your fields.
Is he alone?
No, there's a Mr. Logan with him.
And Mr. Faulkner, is he on duty?
Can't you women think of anything else? No, he's not. So you'll have to get someone else to hold your hand. Come on, let's go.
Ah, Miss Fields, good to see you. You've met Mr. Logan, I think. Thank you, officer. We won't be long.
No, I have to stay. Mr. Logan
is my associate and therefore entitled to a private legal visit. We can take it to your superior if you like, but I can assure you everything is in order. My God, where did they dig her up from?
Oh, they're not all like that. In fact, one of them's been very helpful. You've met him, Mr. Logan. His name is Faulkner.
Yes, that's right, outside the coroner's court.
Oh, that was the second time. I believe you were kind enough to give him a hand when his car was bogged near your farm. I thought I told you that. He was very taken with your Range Rover. The same one I saw outside your factory the night of the fire.
Barbara, I don't know what you're getting.
Oh, you bastard, you set me up. You took that 3,000 and planted it in my flat. That's what I'm getting at.
It all got out of hand. I didn't mean all this to happen. Well, aren't you the clever one? How did you get him to play detective for you, eh?
Never mind. Actually, I should thank you, Phil. If you'd got me that private investigator like you promised, I'd have never found out all of this, would I? You'd have seen to that.
Don't be ridiculous.
And you heard what the coroner said. He cleared me on the arson and murder charge. That means the police will still be looking for whoever did it. By the time I've finished telling them about Range Rovers and dicey land deals.
All right, what do you want?
I'll take the responsibility for the theft. And I'll take a 50% share in George's new business venture, the hotel, in case you've forgotten. And you, Phil, can take care of the legal side of that. Free of charge, naturally.
And what if we don't agree to that?
Then I'll tell them about the Range Rover. And that you knew the money I gave you was stolen.
Well, you've become quite a celebrity.
What do you want, an autograph?
No point. You're finished, Gaffney. Nobody's interested in failures.
That's showbiz.
Get on that line.
Hello, Gaffney. Didn't think it'd be too long before you showed up.
You know her, Mrs. Powell?
Oh, yes, we go back a long way. This is the famous Wentworth bookie. Isn't that correct, Gaffney? Mind you, I'm a bit disappointed in you this time. I really didn't think you were the type to run somebody
over. That was an accident! Stupid bastard ran in front of the car. Mm.
How careless.
You want me to process her?
No. That's okay. You go and supervise the workshop until lunchtime.
Right.
Okay. What's all this about?
You got the charge sheet there, read it.
Don't. Unless you want to start this stint in solitary.
Well, I don't know what you're talking about.
What has Mrs. Morris to do with all of this?
Oh, I see. That's all you're interested in, is it? Well, you can forget it. She's mine.
Meaning? Your name is Margo Gaffney, is that correct? You are charged with escaping legal custody, theft, dangerous driving, leaving the scene of an accident. Is that correct?
You know, for 2 cents, I ought to chuck in this whole thing. I better write to the Guthrie house up in Sydney. Sorry, girls, I can't come. I'm back in the slammer.
Yeah.
You can't trust anybody.
Now, that's not true, Judy. I mean, Tony bailed you out. I was very impressed with him. At least you're not on your own.
Yeah, he's a good kid. And after tomorrow, he'll be running this place himself.
I don't believe that for a minute.
Don't you? Well, what chance do you think I have? A next crim up on aiding and abetting charges. They're going to throw the book at me.
All they've got is purely circumstantial evidence, nothing more.
Well, I hate to say this to you, Mrs. Morris, but all I've got is you. I mean, you're the key witness. What are you going to do when you're sitting up there in that chair? Perjure yourself?
That's my worry, not yours.
Yeah? Not from where I'm sitting, it's not.
Why aren't you in the laundry, Latham?
I'm not feeling well, Miss Ferguson. Must be that cleaning fluid. It's given me a rotten headache. Can I see Mr. Murray?
Headache, eh? I'm surprised.
Eh? What do you mean?
You must be losing your touch, Latham. You don't have to get undressed for a headache examination. But surely a slut like you would have thought of that.
No, Miss Ferguson. It's just a headache, that's all. I'll leave thoughts like that for cheap sluts
like...
Good
morning. And how are you today, Chrissie?
Oh, she's at death's door, Mr. Murray. Very serious. She's got a headache.
Oh, damn. Yes, I was scared that might happen. Obviously, those pills aren't doing their job. Well, I think I'll have to take your blood pressure. Come on.
I mean, am I wrong or what? I always thought the halfway house was for crims.
Ex-crims.
What's the difference? Anyway, first off, Judy does this big panic and pisses me off.
Hang on, I thought you said she gave you some cash.
Big deal, $10. I wasn't gonna get far on that, was I?
What I like about you, Margo, you really appreciate little things people do for you.
Yeah, so Judy helped me out a bit.
Now, hang on a minute, let's get this straight. First of all, you bust out of Vera's vault and go straight to the house in broad bloody daylight.
I had to get a change of clothes, didn't I?
Oh, terrific. And so you endanger the house, and by the looks of things, Judy might end up back in here because you suddenly get fashion conscious.
Look, I would have been home and hosed if that bitch Morris hadn't screamed her head off.
Now, how unreasonable can you get? I mean to say, after all, you were only pinching her car so you could run over somebody.
That was an accident. The stupid bastard ran in front of me. It wasn't my fault.
Oh, I see. Now it's his fault. You know, I'm fed up with you. And if Judy or the house end up in danger over this, I'm going to rearrange your arms and legs.
What about Morris? She pointed the finger. Get that bitch.
Mrs. Morris, she was really good. She really put herself out for us. It was a lovely, cosy little family there for a while, till it all blew up.
So Mrs. Morris is the good guy and Miss Ferguson isn't, hmm?
Yeah. Look, I know I shouldn't be telling you this, but Ferguson is a bent ball dyke and she's bloody dangerous and all.
Yes, well, I certainly don't agree with her work methods, but lesbian, you sure?
Of course I'm sure. Not that that matters. Blimey, it's a wonder I didn't go that way myself.
Oh, come on.
I'm serious. If you knew about my old man, you'd know what I was talking about.
Your father?
Yeah. Dear old loving dad. He was loving, all right. He used to drag me into the cot 3 times a week, twice on Sundays.
God, that's... Well, I'm sorry, Chrissie. I had no idea.
Yeah, well, he's dead now, isn't he? Good riddance. Trouble is, I think it's messed me up as far as other men are concerned. I haven't had much luck, have I? Maybe Ferguson and me are birds of a feather.
Another rubbish. You're a normal, healthy, attractive woman. Now, all you need is a friend, someone to talk to, someone who can give you your confidence back.
Yeah. Yeah, I suppose that would help me.
And I'd like to be that friend, if you wouldn't mind.
Right. You're on.
Has anyone been looking for me, Heather?
Yes, me.
Oh, I'm sorry, Colleen, I really am.
For heaven's sakes, will you calm down and tell me exactly what is going on? Gaffney...
Is she here?
Unfortunately.
Did she say anything about Judy?
Well, all she said was something about you being all hers, whatever that
means.
Yes,
well, I think I know. She was the one that stole my car outside the halfway house. I caught her in the act and then phoned the police.
If she's threatening you, then we've got to report it.
No, that's the least of my worries at the moment.
Why?
Margo has implicated the halfway house, and now Judy has been charged with aiding an escapee.
So?
So what happens to the halfway house if Judy ends up here in prison?
Oh, well, come on, that had to happen.
Now, that's not true, Colleen. Judy's worked damn hard on that place, and now it looks as though the whole thing could go up in smoke. Apart from anything else, it's just not fair on her. I mean, all she wants to do is help people.
Yeah, okay, that was a first mistake.
Really? What about Susie Driscoll? Now, where would she be if it hadn't been for Judy in the halfway house?
Yes, all right, your point is taken. Sorry. Is there anything we can do to help?
Yes. Just hope and pray that Margot keeps her mouth shut. Because if she doesn't...
Oh, come off it, Jude. What did you expect? We're dealing with people who haven't had a fair go. They're not used to people doing things for them, only to them.
Yeah, but Margot knew what would happen if she got caught here.
Tell me, when you're inside, who's the first person you look after?
Yourself, of course, number one. Yeah, all right. Maybe that's what she was doing, but that didn't help the house or me, did it? It's just... I don't want to end up back inside. I don't think I could take it.
Oh, come on, Violet, don't crumble yet. We got to show those official goons just how important this place is.
Yeah, and how are we going to do that? We don't even have council approval to open yet.
Well, okay, we'll play funny buggers and take people in without their approval. Really show our community spirit.
Oh, that's great, isn't it? Then we'd really end up in the soup.
Oh, now, hang on. There's nothing in the rules to say we can't take in unpaying guests, is there?
No. What are you driving at?
Well, the word's out the cops are really clamping down on the pros, especially the street girls. Okay, if the good citizens want them off the streets, let's take them in and give them a hand. You know, get them a decent job and so on. Apart from anything else, it'll look good in court tomorrow.
No, I don't like it. It looks as though we're taking advantage of them.
Well, I suppose we are, but if we don't, that's the end of the house, Jude. And then where do they go when they need help? Joan Ferguson.
All right, you've sold me. But how are we going to fill the house by tomorrow?
Don't have to. All we need is a list of people who'd be willing to come here.
You know something? You're not just a pretty face. I might get to Guthrie House after all.
Start packing your bags.
Oh, Mrs. Davidson, I have Lizzie here for you.
Oh, good. Bring her in. Tell me, Lizzie. Do you remember Dr. Marsden?
Dr. Marsden? He was the one that looked after me when I had my bad ticker.
That's right.
I could never forget him.
Good, because I...
Oh, he was lovely, and he had such a cultured voice.
Did he?
And his hands, God, he could talk with his hands, and they were really gentle.
Well, I'm glad you liked him. You may remember how he felt about your being in prison.
Oh, I didn't put him up to that. That was his idea.
No, I realise that. I've been in contact with him and he has agreed to examine you and submit his report to the parole board.
Good. When is that going to be?
Well, tomorrow. Why?
Oh, I'm wearing my last pair of clean undies for the week. What'll I do?
Well, I suppose you'd better do a little bit of hand washing and hope it dries overnight.
Yeah. Well, I'd better get to it. I hate to rush off like this, Mrs. Davidson, but you know how it is.
Yes, of course. Good luck.
Thank you. Come. Oh, she's a good sport, isn't she, Mrs. N?
Yes, she is. Now, come on, Lizzie, we better hurry.
You all right? Oh, all this excitement. It's given me me palpitations.
Will I get Mr. Murray?
Oh, would you, Mrs. M? I'd walk there myself, and I don't think me poor old legs would carry me.
Lizzie, you have to impress the doctor, not me.
I was just practicing. Come on, let's go.
I heard you got that bar of laundry soap.
Oh, yes, why?
Oh, could you lend it to us, love? I've got to see the doctor tomorrow and I want to wash me undies.
Well, well, if it isn't little Maggie Morris, the prisoner's friend.
It's enough, Gaffney.
Don't bet on it.
Shut up, Margo.
You keep out of this. It's between me and her.
I said that's enough. You're one of a kind, Gaffney. You know that? It's always somebody else's fault, isn't it? Never yours. Tell me, who was it that made you break out of Barnhurst? Anyone we know? Who bullied you into going to the halfway house and stealing my car? I'd love to know who that was, because they've got a lot to answer for.
Very funny.
Shut up! Now, Bryant goes to court tomorrow. And if things go wrong for her, that's the finish of the halfway house and she ends up in here. Now, who do we blame for that, Gaffney?
You! You're the one that yelled copper.
Not soon enough.
It was her fault. She yelled copper.
Does this mean I have to get out of this room too?
No, just don't use the ashtrays. Hey, how's it looking?
Well, we're not broke, if that's what you mean. The trouble is we can't touch what's left until those council idiots give us the rubber stamp.
Maybe we ought to get Doran to do us a couple of forgeries.
Hey, gal.
Hello.
Maxine?
Yeah, I'll get him.
Nice, bud.
Max!
G'day, kid. You getting any?
She won't be a minute. Spud, you'll be careful, won't you? I just don't think she should get in any trouble till she has to go to court.
Yeah, no worries.
We're only worried for her, Spud.
I mean, we want you to have a good time and everything. Just don't aggravate the cops, okay?
What do you reckon we're gonna do? Exhibitions on the footpath?
Of course not.
Then get off our backs, will ya? Fair enough, we made a blue. But hell, we've busted a gut trying to make up for it.
Yeah, I know that, love. It's just we got $300 riding on you, remember?
How could I forget? You're playing it a bit heavy, Jude. Spud?
Gaffney, I'm afraid I've got some bad news. Senior Detective Herbert just rang. The man you hit died about a half an hour ago. If there's anything I can do to help. I'm sorry about what happened in the recreation room. We both said things that we just didn't mean.
You bitch! Gaffney, you know what trouble is this? You dump me, you bitch! Dump me! I'm gonna be in here forever! So you're dead, lady. You're dead!
Let it go!
Meg, where are you?
No, Steve, it was my fault. I shouldn't have come in here. She's just had some bad news.
You're going to have to report it.
No.
Don't do me any favours, screw, because it won't make no difference!
Is that you, Maxine?
Yeah.
Well, where the hell have you been?
Told you. Went out with Spud.
That was last night. Now, what would you have done if the cops had come around checking on you?
Oh, geez, Jude, I didn't think. They didn't, did they?
No, they didn't. You know, you're not the only pebble in the beach. I got my own problems, too. I got a face up to the bench this morning.
Yeah, well, don't go on about it, Jude, okay? I'm sorry. We were having a good time and I forgot, all right? Anyway, I'm back now, so what's the big deal? And you still got your $300, which is all you seem to be worried about lately.
What's the verdict, Doc? Am I going to snuff it?
Are you going to what?
Snuff it. You know, snuff it.
Oh, I see. Snuff it, eh? Let me put it like this, Mrs. Birdsworth. If any of my other patients had your medical record, I'd be very worried. But you?
Yeah.
I think you'll see me out.
Oh, good. Don't say that. They'll never let me out. What's happened? Has me old ticker fixed itself up or something?
No, no, nothing like that. Medically speaking, you're a very sick person, or should be. You've got high blood pressure, angina, and an impaired left ventricle.
Oh, God, that sounds good. Hey, what was that last one?
Impaired left ventricle.
Bloody ripper. They should have let me out now.
I seem to remember a time when you didn't want to leave here. What changed your mind?
Oh, don't get me wrong, Doc. I've never been very fond of this place, but all my old mates were in here, and when I was on the outside, I didn't have anyone to talk to.
Bit lonely, eh?
Yeah, you know me. I like a good chin wag.
Yes, I gathered that. Mr. Faulkner. Now, my advice to you is gentle exercise, a healthy diet, and not too much excitement.
Prison life and excitement seem to go together.
Yes, that's what I'm worried about. I'll be putting that in my report.
Oh, and don't forget me repaired ventilator.
A what?
Repaired ventilator. It's very rare.
So I think if we can convince the court that Judy's contribution to the house can only help the community, this charge they've got against her will look pretty insignificant.
Well, I hope you're right, Tony. And you intend taking in prostitutes to strengthen your argument?
Young prostitutes. Kids. The Susie Driscolls. That's why I'd like to talk to any women you've got in here that might fit the bill.
Oh, we don't have many like Susan Driscoll. There is one young girl in for prostitution. Perhaps you'd like to speak to her?
Yeah.
Would you arrange to have Penny Seymour taken down to an interview room, please?
Forget it.
Oh, come on, Penny. You didn't even let me finish.
You don't have to. I got the picture. Look, mate, I may not be the greatest hooker in the world, but I can still earn a buck. I'm not ready for charity yet.
It's got nothing to do with charity. Well, all right, look, forget it. Forget about us putting you straight.
You can straighten me out any time you like, as long as you pay for it.
On my salary, no way.
Pity.
Will you help us get the kids off the streets, then?
You don't understand, do you? Kids bring top dollar. The pimps love them. Can you imagine what would happen to me if I started retiring them?
You know what the halfway house is about, don't you? Don't you think it's worthwhile?
Of course I do. But it's not for me.
If we don't have people listed as wanting to go there by tomorrow, it could be closed down.
Okay. Put my name down for the house. But just don't expect me to turn up there, that's all.
You're beautiful, do you know that?
You're not bad yourself.
Oh, why don't you watch where you're going?
Yeah, I'll do that. I could hurt somebody, couldn't I?
Judy.
You're a guest here, don't forget it. What do you want?
Nothing. I was going to say good luck, but forget it. Spud? Get off the bloody bed, will you? I just made it.
What's crawling on you? You're starting to sound like that bitch downstairs.
There's nothing wrong with her. It's this place, that's all. It's giving me the creeps.
So cut out.
I can't.
Why not?
You know why, stupid. If I vanish, so does Judy's dough.
Big deal. $300.
Yeah, it is a big deal. When was the last time you saw that much dough?
Next week.
What are you talking about?
Me and the boys have been watching a truck.
No.
Yes. Look, it's small stuff, easy to get rid of. The slack that drives has got a real eye for the chicks. So you take his mind off the truck while me and the boys finish the job.
No way.
You're not listening, Maxie. This is big bread. You'll be able to give Fatso a 300 and disappear. That's what's bugging you, isn't it? And what about the money you owe me?
Yeah, but...
But nothing, you're doing it. Unless you want me and the boys to come round here and redecorate this dump. You know what I'm talking about, don't you?
Hi. Is Jude upstairs?
Nah, you just missed her.
Oh, damn it. How was she?
Didn't say much, but I reckon she was pretty uptight.
Yeah, I don't blame her. If things don't go right, she's back inside. I wouldn't swap places with her. Well, I wonder if I could get there in time. I might as well give it a go.
Tony!
Hey, why the long face?
I don't want to bug you, but I got hassles.
Spud?
How'd you guess?
Intuition. Spud and hassle seem to go together. What's the problem?
Spud and the boys are going to do a job.
Job?
Yeah, they're going to...
Oh, now, come on. This is just between you and me, OK? I can't help unless I know what the trouble is.
They're going to do a truck over. Spud reckons I've got to help.
Me and my big mouth. What the hell do I say to that?
Yeah, well, look, I don't know what to do either. I mean, I don't want to do it, but if he gets
Listen,
heavy...
I don't want to speak ill of the dead, love, but that guy's a moron. Just go to the cops.
No, I'm not putting the pigs onto him.
Well, it looks like I've got a bit to learn. Well, it sounds crazy, but this boy thinks better over a cup of coffee. So don't move. We've got a lot of talking to do.
Now, Miss Bryant, this halfway house...
Driscoll House.
I beg your pardon?
Driscoll House, that's what it's called, Your Worship.
It would be easier if I were told these things before the hearing.
I'm sorry, Your Worship. I was given no information to that effect.
Oh, he couldn't have known, you see. We only named it last night.
I take it the name Driscoll holds some significance.
Oh, yes. It's named after our first success, Susie Driscoll. We picked her up off the streets before the pimps were going to push heroin into
Your
her.
Your Worship.
I mean, she's only 17. Now, that's what the halfway house
is
all
about.
Yes,
yes. All right, Miss Bryant. You may hand out brochures after the hearing.
I believe Driscoll House employs a Mr. Anthony Berman. Is that correct?
Yes.
And are we to believe Mr. Berman didn't see Gaffney either?
He couldn't have.
Why? Because he said so?
No. Because he wasn't there.
Hey, the coffee's not that bad. What about that talk we were going to have?
I've made up my mind, Tony. I'm getting out. If Spud turns up, tell him I shot through.
Are you sure you're doing the right thing?
No. But I got no choice, have I? Sorry about the hassles.
No, that's what we're here for. Hassle House, that's us. Listen, Maxie, what if I had a talk with Spud?
No, he'll kill you. I'm not kidding, Tony, I know him. And if he can't do it, he'll get one of the boys to do it.
Well, look, if he's that dangerous, you've got to go to the cops. I mean, no, it's not
the
done thing.
Look, will you just listen? There are biker gangs everywhere and Spud knows them all. Someone would get me sooner or later. At least I'd be safe in the slammer.
Well...
Look, I've got to go, Tony. Spud said he'd tear this place to pieces if I didn't do what he said. And I can't do that to Jude.
You know the cops will put out a warrant for you.
Yeah. Sorry about the 300. I'll pay it back, honest.
Oh, forget it. That's our worry. Have you got any bread to keep you going?
Nah, but I'll be okay.
Yeah. No arguments. I just wish I could do more.
You are Mrs. Margaret Morris, and you are presently employed as a prison officer at the Wentworth Detention Centre. Is that correct?
Yes.
And do you know the accused, Judith Bryant?
I do.
And where did you first meet her?
At the detention centre.
She was, in fact, an inmate there, is that correct?
Yes.
Tell me, Mrs. Morris, what was she sentenced for?
You can't ask me that, can you?
The question is out of order.
I'm simply questioning the credibility of the accused, Your Worship. You may recall she went to great pains telling us of her dedicated work in getting youngsters away from the drug scene. Unfortunately, her record indicates that she was convicted of drug trafficking herself.
You can't say that. You can't mention Judy's record and here you're prejudicing the court.
If you don't mind, Mrs. Morris, I'm conducting these proceedings. Strike the reference to the accused record. Continue and restrict yourself to matters currently before the court.
Yes, Your Worship. On the afternoon of the 9th, which is the day in question, what was your purpose in going to Driscoll House?
I promised Miss Bryant I'd call in and see how things were progressing.
So one would imagine that she'd be eager to show you around?
I suppose so.
Yes, and did she? Or did she steer clear from certain sections of the building?
She didn't attempt to hide anything, if that's what you mean.
Well, what was her reaction when you first saw Gaffney stealing your car?
Well, I can't really say. My attention was taken up with what was happening in the street below.
Mrs. Morris, in your opinion, did Bryant know of Margot Gaffney's presence at the halfway house? Well?
I wasn't aware that I could be asked to pass an opinion.
Restrict yourself to direct questions, Mr. Hastings.
Yes, Your Worship. Mrs. Morris, did Bryant give any indication that she knew of Gaffney's presence?
My answer could jeopardize the future of Driscoll House, which, in my opinion, is one of the finest projects the department has ever been involved in. I am not prepared to answer that question.
There's been enough time wasted already this morning. In future, I'd advise prosecuting counsel not to waste the court's time with hostile witnesses. Mrs. Morris, you will answer the question or be charged with contempt of court. I'm quite sure you won't want to return to Wentworth Detention Centre as an inmate.
Well, Mrs. Morris?
Lizzie, the prob board's waiting for you.
Oh, hang on.
What on earth are you doing?
What do you reckon? Do I look as though I've got a fever?
No, get out of here.
Ah, Mrs. Birdsworth, sit down, would you? And now we won't keep you waiting. This must be quite a strain on you.
No, I'm all right.
Well, Dr. Marsden has written quite a comprehensive report for us, and you'll be pleased to hear that we wholeheartedly agree with his recommendations.
Oh, that's nice. What's that mean?
Yes, Mrs. Birdsworth, you'll be given your parole license.
Congratulations, Lizzie.
Thank you, Mrs. Davidson. I wonder if Dr. Marsden does house calls. I'd still like him to look after me when I'm in the halfway house.
Now, that won't be necessary, Mrs. Birdsworth.
Oh, I think so. He knows me history. Anyway, I wouldn't like anyone else to look after me.
No, you don't understand. You see, according to Dr. Marsden's report, you're going to need quite a lot of care. And we're worried that you won't get that care at the halfway house.
Of course I will. Jude's my mate. She'll look after me.
Nevertheless, we feel it necessary to place a proviso on the license. It's only for your own good.
Proviso? What is it?
That your parole be suspended until we can find a suitable place for you. Of course, there are dozens of old people's homes about, but we must find one that has the proper medical attention available.
Old people's home?
Yes, Mrs. Birdsworth. A place where you can relax and mix with people of your own age. Don't worry. You'll be well looked after.
Oh, hello. What's going on then? Oh, looks like someone's in for it.
No, just some of my customers come to visit. Probably still want their cut.
Hang on. Looks like they're bringing someone in. Oh, must be a real toff to get all that attention. That bitch Morris. Trust her to get a ride to work with the cops. I wonder why they got her by the arms. Maybe she's sick. Almost looks like they're bringing her in under arrest, don't it?
me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun arrives.